morning to one and all. Today I am going to tell about mitochondria. This will cover third semester biochemistry and for biotechnology group papers students. And this is nothing but in this particular chapter you will be learning about the structure of mitochondria, synthesis of ATP, and what do you say, electron transport chain, oxidative phosphorylation, and many so on, right? So before going, and high energy compounds, many more. So before going in detail to the subject, first you have to learn what do you mean by mitochondria, right? So as you all know, mitochondria, this was first introduced by Carl Benda in 1898. Got it? Next, he first stated what is the actual structure that is lying behind the mitochondria. Actually, mitochondria means, mito means red, chondria means granule like structure. So mitochondria is nothing but this is a double membrane bound granular structure. So mitochondria is a very important organelle in a eukaryotic cell. As because of this mitochondria, the whole power of the cell is generated, and in this particular organelle only energy is generated in the form of ATP, and it is very vital to each and every organelle of the living organism. So how this particular mitochondria is structure is identified and how this particular structure is known. So as I said earlier, mitochondria is a double membrane bound granular structure. Structure of mitochondria. This is the outer membrane. Next, so this is the ultra structure of mitochondria, and as I said earlier, this organelle is very important for your energy production and energy synthesis, and it is being distributed to each and every organelle and cells of your body, and this is a very vital organ. Next, and as I said earlier, this is also very important. Mitochondrial DNA is very important during maternal DNA transportation. Next, this is known, coming to the function, composition of your mitochondria. Mitochondria is composed of DNA, RNA, lipid, protein molecules. And coming to the important functions of mitochondria, mitochondria performs a very important role during the synthesis of ATP, and hence it is known as powerhouse of the cell. And one more thing, mitochondria plays a very important role during the breakdown of food molecules into smaller, and during this metabolism, which comes with the catabolism and anabolism of your food particles and your carbohydrates, amino acids into smaller molecules, which generates energy, and it is produced and synthesized to each and every organelle of your body. And with this particular ATP, the body will get energy and you can do your regular daily work. So mitochondria is known as powerhouse of the cell. And again I will repeat it, mitochondria is known as double membrane granular structure. As I said earlier, mitochondria is nothing but, it is, mito means red and chondria means granule like structure. See, this is a granular like structure, and inside this thread like conversions are present. And here you can see small F0 and F1 particles are there, where the oxidative phosphorylation takes place. Mitochondria generally useful in your Krebs cycle also, because this is the main source point for your synthesis of your ATP. So this is the ultrastructure of mitochondria, and these are the function and composition of your mitochondria. In the next class, I will be explaining you about high energy compounds, classification of high energy compounds, and synthesis of ATP. Thank you.